aprender cómo usar el verbo pensar con de, pensar en, e infinitivo, pensar infinitivo. Primero revisamos pensar, que es un verbo que cambia en el raíz. Pienso, piensas, piensa, pensamos. Nota que aquí no cambia. Pensáis, piensan. ¿Ok? Tienes los cambios aquí, por eso que es un verbo de la bota. ¿Ok? Repite. Yo pienso. Tú piensas. Él piensa. Nosotros pensamos, vosotros pensáis, ellos piensan. Cuidado, piensan, piensa, piensas, pienso, pero pensamos, pensáis. ¿Ok? El I hace una diferencia. Ok, cuando usamos pensar más infinitivo, es para hablar de what you're planning to do or thinking about doing. So you conjugate the verb pensar and then add an infinitive. For example, pienso comer unos tacos. I'm planning on eating tacos or I'm thinking about eating tacos. Piensas dormir. You're thinking about sleeping. Nosotros pensamos jugar baloncesto. We are thinking about playing basketball or we're planning on playing basketball. Even though this doesn't say to plan, okay, it's the verb to think. In English, it can be translated as to plan, okay, in this context, when it's followed by an infinitive. Pienso comer. I'm thinking about eating or I'm planning on eating. Okay, ahora vamos a hablar de pensar de y pensar que. These two are used when you're going to ask for and when you're going to give opinion. ¿Qué piensas de? To ask someone's opinion. Yo pienso que? To give your opinion. Okay? You can also use them with other forms of the verb. Let's look at some examples. ¿Qué piensas de Shakira? Okay? You see it's here in the question. Piensas de, and then ask what the thing is you want the opinion about. You want to ask someone's opinion about a person, a place, an activity. And when you give your opinion, pienso que. So, the de in the question becomes a que in the answer. Pienso que, and here's my opinion, canta muy bien y es muy bonita. Okay, so, pienso que, I could also add in here Shakira. Pienso que Shakira canta muy bien y es muy bonita. And I think you, pienso que debes sacar apuntes. I hope you're taking notes on this. Okay, so make sure you've written down, pensar de, pensar que, to ask and give opinion. Let's look at our last one, pensar en. Okay, finalmente pensar en. Se usa pensar en para hablar de los pensamientos. To ask or talk about who or what someone is thinking. So let's look at some examples. I could say in this question, en qué piensa Luke, and then we're going to take the en from the question and it's going to appear in the middle of the sentence. Luke piensa en baloncesto. So notice here in the question it's at the beginning, but in the statement it comes after pensar. Luke piensa en baloncesto. And this is a noun here, okay? But we're going to see down here when we talk about what Casey's thinking about, that you can also use a verb. En qué piensa Casey? Again, we have en at the beginning of the sentence. Casey piensa en montar a caballo. So here we have a verb. So you can use nouns, thinking about a thing, or thinking about an activity and use a verb. We're going to practice them some more into class tomorrow. One more time, let's recap. We have pensar en, to talk about what someone is thinking, to ask about who or what someone is thinking about, excuse me. We have pensar infinitivo, to talk about your plans. And we have pensar de and pensar que, to ask for opinion and express opinion. I hope you remember tomorrow.